she cut my body, no one let me go. She get the fire, but they are no fake at it, go. He don't they enter, but they all fell at me, yo. I know feel them, my baby, oh, my cameo. Ah, la, la, le, Friday. Tell me, oh, basun, le, oh. Say, I, de, mi, ke, le, oh. Fun, mi, lori, bi, ke, le. Baby, my body, oh. My body, oh. I don't want your new neighbors to know my. My body, oh, 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 yeah, go body, oh, oh. I don't want your new neighbors to know my name. If your body na cause, I go study, girl, if your body na road, I go follow, go. Oh, say me, be pay mo to put down, yo. Oh, say me, be pay mo to fair polo. But I want, can you go for love? I'm getting tired, but I won't give up. No, no. I want, can you go for long? I'm getting tired, but I won't give up. No, no. Baby, my body, oh, my body, oh. I don't want your new neighbors to know my name. My body, oh, 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 yeah, go body, oh. I don't want your new neighbors to know my name.
Welcome, welcome to the Smiling Sufferer podcast.
That's your breath first.
I had to just sprint downstairs because someone's trying to get in. But yeah, it's your boy Corey on the mic. Goddamn, who? Yeah. Hey. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah, it's Corey on the mic, man. Sorry about that, guys. Sorry for the technical glitches. But yeah, today I have G with me, aka the black MLS. Happy
M. The G Wag, bro. The black G Wag.
How far now, Wally?
Aka the money maker, the poker winner.
Oh, really? You know, that's how you feel?
That's how I'm feeling, man. Back to back.
You're here to dance on your haters, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, we had poker last night. I missed it, but seems like Wally had a good night.
I did.
Man, how you feeling about that Burna album now?
Bro, he's breaking charts too, man.
I know we keep coming back to it. So what are the charts looking like right now for Burna?
I think the UK.
Or the Twice as Tall album.
UK, he's number five.
He's number five. Yeah. So what, he dropped from number one to five?
He debuted at number one. Okay. But I think he's... He tweeted it recently. He says, congrats, Burna Boy. Twice as Tall debuts at number five. And it's the highest new entry
nice.
To the UK's official album. So I guess it's the official chart. And it's
I see.
This is a tweet from an official chart, okay. Which is a registered account on Twitter. And it's about the UK official chart. So
okay,
it's a big achievement for an album, you know, a Nigerian album to be on there. I think in the US, I saw someone post, I think it's at 11, the last they checked.
11? I'm looking at the charts right now. I don't see it on there.
I don't
there.
Know what anyone, I saw one. But I, maybe but it's iTunes they were showing me too.
Yeah, it's probably iTunes. I'm looking at the Billboard charts for the US, the albums. I'm not sure if he made it.
I don't think so.
Or maybe it just hasn't been finalized. Yeah, I don't know.
But I think it's iTunes that people were talking about.
Okay.
Apple Music, I think. I don't know.
Interesting. The album, you know, I remember saying that I wasn't gonna, you know, give any final
conclusions
there,
like,
on it.
If you go on, you know, Apple Music right now,
yeah,
and you go to like your browse, there's like a category says what we're in, you know, like a category of albums they're loving. Apple Music is loving. Twice as Tall is there.
Okay.
If you go to, obviously, he's no longer on New Music because more new music has come out, but he was on the cover of New Music Daily. But even if you go to New Music Daily, the playlist, you know, he's still in there. You know, you go to top 100, what do they call it? Top 100 Nigeria, he's there. Top 100 in a lot of countries. He's number one in, I think, 48 countries now.
Yeah.
Yeah, he put it out there. It's a good, you know, achievement to definitely have. And
we're talking about twice as tall album, by the way.
Yeah. So it's number one. He's picked number one on Apple Music in 48 countries. A lot of African countries. So UK was number one on Apple Music. Mm-hmm. That's. But then the official UK chart outside of Apple Music, he's number five. Okay. But on Apple Music, he's number one. In a lot of countries, you know, I'm trying to see any Africa. There's Portugal, there's France, there's United Arab Emirates, there's, you know, Sweden, there's Luxembourg, Estonia. You know, it's a countries I didn't even think Burna Boy's music reached. You know, Cyprus, Belgium.
Yeah, so it seems like he's doing everywhere. He's doing pretty good everywhere in terms of sales, with the exception of possibly the US. I don't think it made top 100 in the US. Just judging.
Well, yeah,
this.
I don't think he made a top 100 in the US, but, you know, it is fine.
Which is fine.
The US is not very open to...
No, they're not.
To music.
They're not. They're not.
And they're very, very... US is very, very... not the word I'm looking for is... not naive. What's the other word instead of naive? Like, they don't know much about things, culture outside.
So outside like, of for the US, instance, right?
Like... With the whole Burna and, you know, Beyonce thing going on now.
Yeah, let's talk about that. No, so please help explain to people what happened.
So Burna Boy, you know, obviously he wasn't on the Black is King video.
Yes.
But it was an album. In fact, he had a wonderful song. And I know a lot of people actually like the song, Jara. In fact, they love the song. Now, granted, Beyonce is Beyonce. And Beyonce has a lot of fans. And a lot of her fans just heard of Burna Boy for the first time.
Yes.
Through that album. And they loved it. But he wasn't in the Black is King video. Now he did an interview. He did an interview with Breakfast Club.
Let me play it real quick.
Okay.
I had it queued up. You gotta be kidding me. I just freaking queued this thing up. It's gone. Can you text it to me?
Nah, but we can put it later. But he's so he had an interview, and you know, Charlamagne was basically just talking about, you know, Africa and bridging the gap between Africa and here and stuff like that. And, you know, he said, you know, does Burna like the, you know, the way Beyonce is bridging the gap between, you know, with the Black is King album, Afrobeats, and I can understand why he asked that question, because, I mean, I feel like mainstream media, mainstream America, Drake was the first person to introduce people to Afrobeats with his Views album.
Yes.
You know, you have songs like Controller, One Dance. You know, they're very Afrobeat-ish, especially One Dance, you know. But it was like people like Wizkid that benefited from it. But Beyonce's Black is King is a bigger introduction to Afrobeats for a lot more people, because people will get to see the likes of Yemi Alade and Mr. Easy and names that you don't know about. And it's very cultural. You know, personally, I don't think she appropriated the culture. I personally think... she did a good job.
And by appropriating the culture, you mean you don't think she was taking advantage?
So taking advantage is a rare word to use, because Beyonce would always, can always easily take advantage of you. Mm-hmm. Same way Drake can always easily take advantage of you. But the question is, are you willing to be taken advantage of by them? Probably, yes. Because you feel like there's a bigger outcome.
You have more to gain.
More to gain. It's not a personal problem with them. They're not doing anything bad. They're just the bigger stars. And they will do what's more comfortable for them, which is just like business.
There is a huge fundraising.
You know, it's just like business. You go into a business deal, and somebody who has an investor that has more money than you can say, "Hey, man, I want 80% of your company," and it's up to you to say, "Sure."
So I guess what you're trying to explain is that, yes, Beyonce might have something to gain, but you have a lot more to gain by being associated with them.
I believe that's the general norm.
Okay.
Now, I don't know the business behind the whole thing, because we're just fans. So we see it as a fan. We love the album, the way the album was shot. But I don't know how Beyonce's interactions were with this artist. I don't know how they were treated outside of what we saw, the final project. I don't really know the business behind it. I don't know if there were deals signed. I don't know if there were supposed to be agreements. I mean, we look at Drake and Wizkid. We're all happy when Wizkid was on One Dance. And then Wizkid sang Come Closer with Drake. And we were all so excited about it. But Wizkid shot two videos and Drake was in none of them.
That's true.
Some can say that, man, Drake didn't even show him justice. In fact, for the longest for the longest time, Drake was not even acknowledging that song until when he realized how big the song has gotten. And there was a time in Canada that he started, he performed it for the first time at a Caribbean party because they kept playing it. For the first time ever, he's kind of like, okay, this song is big. This is my, I'll play it, I'll sing it. And obviously he went to O2 Arena, and Wizkid is very big in England. So what did he do? He brought Wizkid out to perform the song with him on stage. It's all marketing. But, you know, Wiz would do that and know that, okay, this is big for me, you know. But at the end of the day, how does he really feel about Drake? We don't know, because he shot two videos and Drake wasn't in any of them. So we don't really know the business behind the whole thing. So, but anyways, I personally think, when I say she didn't appropriate, I feel like she paid enough respect.
Okay.
In terms of letting the culture flow. She wasn't...
But there were some allegations, though.
There have been allegations. You know, there have been allegations.
There was an allegation that I know that someone brought to my attention. I'll just snitch on you. You brought it to my attention.
So there have been tweets somebody's told me about. And yes, that a girl that was in the video complained about being paid maybe £250 or something like that.
In the girl that was in the video, in the Black is King.
Black is King. She was also the one in Joro video with Wizkid. But when you go on our page, there's nothing like that there anymore. And the guy who sent it to me, or so he's...
Wait, so you're saying the allegation is that Beyonce...
Not Beyonce. Whoever is in charge.
Whoever is in charge paid...
The girl £250.
This model, right?
And they didn't tell her it was...
Wait, £250 or £150?
I think it was £250.
£250.
Something, it was not more than...
To be in the video.
But she didn't
know
it was
in
a video.
Disney production.
They didn't tell her it was all that.
And they didn't tell her it was...
According to the tweets, I can't find them anymore. So I was just going to say it's an allegation. I believe the girl might have deleted it. I believe... Who knows? Maybe it was photoshopped.
Okay. So as a result of this allegation, which hasn't been proven...
It hasn't been proven yet.
People are saying that perhaps Beyonce was... either appropriating or taking advantage of,
personally, I would not put that down to her. I'll put that down to whoever's in charge of the project. I can understand why they might have not told them it's a movie. It's probably part of the NDA and to keep it under wraps. But £250 and you're in Brown Skin Girl video. It's kind of like, bro, come on, man. But Beyonce probably didn't know about that.
But then what's the market rate for stuff like that? That's another question.
That's also another question.
And then was she a main feature? I remember the girl in the Joro video. Yeah, I remember. She was the one that was dancing.
She's one of the girls in one of the scenes. Right? But then again, to your right, because there's so many of them in there. So
exactly.
If you budget it at 250 times exactly. 100 people or 200 people, that's a lot more. So
exactly.
At the end of, but then look, when it comes to stuff like that, I don't really care. When people tell me that, this man got paid 10 times more than this woman or this other person in the movie, I'm like, because he has a... agent that got him that deal.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's really just what it is. It's like, bro, this is my value and I'm not taking this money. Do you get what I'm saying? So it might be boiled down to that, and that's part of the taking advantage. Someone says, hey, I'm going to pay you $250 to be in a Beyonce project. And you're like, hell yeah. And then you come out and you see how big it is and you're like, oh, well, maybe I should have gotten fired. That's your luck. But all that, I don't even think, even if this is true, I don't think she personally was like, no, paying him $250. Obviously, that's not her job.
Okay.
You know, but... I feel, but
we have to be sure that
there have been allegations. So the main allegations have been, what has she done for Africa?
Yes.
And it's true. What has she done for Africa? But do you know what I say in return? Why do Africans always need other people to do stuff for us? Let's do stuff for ourselves.
We need to empower ourselves.
And that's what Bernard speaks about. Do yourself.
We need to empower ourselves.
I don't need Beyonce to come and validate or do anything.
We need to
for,
stop asking to be at the table.
I don't need her to do that for Africa to be great. I do like the fact that she made an album. And let's be honest. Beyonce did not wake up and say, I want to help Afrobeat.
No.
The same way Drake did not wake up and say, I want to help Afrobeat.
She's trying to make an album.
She's trying to make an album and make sales and be relevant.
And by the way, the album has been climbing up the charts.
Of course, and stay relevant. But I tell the thing I did say in the last show we spoke about this was that she didn't have to do this.
Especially
when the album did not do too well. Mm-hmm. Having to go and invest in doing a video. And obviously it's Beyonce. She would do everything grand slam. So the video, I told you, the production of the videos were A1. Mm-hmm. The idea, the concept was A1. And I don't feel like she mimicked or clowned or, you know, like
made a mockery
of the culture.
Let me play the clip in question. It's a very short clip. So this is Burna Boy on the
Beyonce incident.
On
why he's not in Black.
He's on the Breakfast Club. Yeah. And they're asking, you know, about his feature on the album.
All right, go on.
You know, people celebrate it over here. We praise it. For the African culture, but it's been criticized and people say that she's appropriating African culture. What do you think about that?
Michelle well, always got the question.
Well, I think you should ask her about that.
His reaction was hilarious.
I know, because if you asked me, boy.
You can tell there's a lot he wants to say.
Comment on that right now.
But it's kind of bridging the gap like you want, though, right?
Charlotte knows how to ask the question.
Well, not like I want.
So,
but yeah, man. Let's skip that.
Let's skip that, yeah. So, now, so let's stop there now. So, that video then came out.
Yes.
Now, Beyonce's...
And if you did a lot of the speculation that I made.
Now, so let me get back to what I was saying. So the first things that first came out was, what has she done for Africa? She's never toured in Africa. She's never done anything for Africa. Mm-hmm. And I returned and said, look, I don't care. Personally, I don't care.
Yeah.
I think she did an amazing album. I think she did an amazing job letting people do, you know, showcasing the culture, and the album was shot in different parts of Africa.
Yeah.
I do feel like Beyonce is kind of petty though, because I kind of felt like the video that was going to get the most love from her was going to be the one with Shatta Wale. Mm-hmm. And the reason I say this is because that nigga has been the person being on her dick the most since this thing dropped.
Yeah.
So I kind of see why, I mean, it's a good song, but I kind of see why he was the only one who had a video with her actually in it. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm pretty sure you've said it. The Carters notice things like this. People say it a lot.
They do.
So now back to the whole thing. So people came out and said, what does she do for Africa? And I said, look, it's business. It's business, but she's done the business in a way where she could have done this with only American artists, and she decided to pick Afrobeat artists. She's picked the biggest Afrobeat artist in Wiz, it was Wiz, Burner, and the other people, and she did a good job. So now, people have said Burner Boy has issues with her, and it started when he was first asked about the collab when the album dropped, and there's a little nonchalant about it. He said, look, I never met her before. And they just contacted me through my mom. I made 3 songs. They picked one, and that was it. It sounded like to him it was just business.
Yeah.
I'm guessing everybody expected him to be more excited.
Yeah.
That it's Beyonce.
I'm like, oh, Beyonce.
Now let's be honest. As big as Beyonce is in the world, I don't always have to be excited. Like, not everyone has to be as excited as you are about her. Now there should be respect.
There should be.
And from this interview, Burna Boy actually gives her respect by not saying what he really thinks.
Yeah,
but here's where we always get this
he's
thing
trying
wrong.
To sell an album.
So yes.
He doesn't want to.
But here's where we get
bags.
This thing wrong is that we put everybody on a pedestal. And some people deserve to be. Beyonce deserves to be put on a pedestal. But just because you put someone on a pedestal doesn't mean I have to put them on that same pedestal.
Yeah.
So.
How about the people that would say. Or what if it's just the Nigerian in him? There's also that factor. Remember we talked
yes,
about it on
yeah,
the
okay, but
where we talked about the fact that...
So
let me explain. Right, we talked about the fact that we Niger people, we can
be proud.
Very, very prideful people.
We're proud. Yeah.
We don't like to kiss anyone's ass. If we're going to kiss anyone's ass, usually there's money at the end of it. And there's some kind of exchange. But usually if we're not really getting anything out of it, for the most part, Nigerian people, at least a lot of people that I know, we're very, very, very prideful.
I can give an example to butcher that point is, look at the new Drake song with Lil Durk.
Yeah.
If you look at Lil Durk's page, he's been all over excited about it. But when Drake dropped this, which that song is not going to be as big as One Dance, Wizkid wasn't even that promoting it.
No,
that
he
much.
Wasn't.
He wasn't.
He wasn't.
He was kind of like, eh.
He wasn't.
You know, which.
He wasn't.
He was like, eh, you know, it's another thing. So
it's a reflection of our.
Yes,
of the way
and it
we
might seem like
sometimes.
You're ungrateful.
Yes.
Which, but I can also counter it and say, do you guys understand one thing? And this is where I get back to the Americans being naive. That's the word I was looking for. Lil Durk, DaBaby, Lil Baby, all these artists that are hot in America.
Mm-hmm.
Cannot sell out O2 Arena like Wizkid and Burna Boy has and Davido. Let's be honest.
No, they can't.
You guys, these guys are big in the States.
Mm-hmm.
But outside of the States, Wizkid and Burna Boy, you can quote me anywhere.
They don't
go look on YouTube and look at the views of these people's.
Yeah.
Burna Boy has 1 billion streams of his last album. Davido has 1 billion streams of his song.
Streams.
Guess who just celebrated
billions
a billion? Guess
streams.
Who just celebrated 1 billion streams too?
Who is
Drake.
It? Drake. Oh.
Yeah. DaBaby might never get 1 billion streams.
That's true.
Lil Durk, all these people together might never get 1 billion streams. So they might be bigger to you here.
Yeah.
And we might be hearing them more. They might be hottest artists here. Mm-hmm. But in fact, like going there, even a social media following, these people, some of them don't even have as much. So you might see them as this is just some upcoming, you know. And I like the baby. That's why I just brought him up. But you know, you look at the baby has 14 million followers. Davido has 17. You get, so it's like Wizkid has 11, so Wizkid has less. But you look, and that's someone that is hot. The baby is hot right now, you know, and that's why I'm calling his name. But like you look at you look at them, and you look at like the sellouts. Burner Boy actually has the least; he has 5. But you look at he sold out Wembley Arena.
Yeah,
these are features that these people
and sometimes followership
doesn't correlate
on social media.
You're right.
There's some
but we look at it, and these people don't know that is that these people are actually they really are giants.
Yeah, they are.
Some can even argue that they make more bread than some of these American artists. We can argue because look at Wizkid got paid. They said the rumor was he got paid almost 900,000
for
performance in India. Only other person that has gotten paid that high was Kanye.
It's ridiculous.
So think about it this way. You know that. Think about it. 900, almost $1 million for one performance for royalty in India. Mm-hmm. As an African artist, you can't fathom. As an American, you can't think that someone from Africa can make that much from a show. So. There's that naivety behind it that, yes, Burna Boy is an upcoming. So when this whole thing happened, Beyonce fans have been abusing him. He's ungrateful. Mm-hmm. He steals Fela's songs. Somebody came out and said he's proud and good luck in your crumbling career. I'm like, this is his 5th or 6th album. Mm-hmm. You're just getting to know him now.
Yeah, he's been around.
So for you, you think he's up and coming. He's been around for a minute. He's done... massively.
Look, whether they like it or not, they're gonna have to respect Afrobeats.
They have to respect, and that's why I have an issue with the fans here is that at the end of the day, you're just being naive. The world is just not America. The world is the world. So it's like there are more countries than the United States. So I understand that in the United States, these boys cannot sell out Madison Square Garden. They're going to be small lineups in Coachella and stuff like that. They're not going to sell out the main ones. But we also understand that how many people in America and how many people in the rest of the world, they have a bigger following outside. So
yeah.
Burna Boy is not an upcoming artist. He's not a small boy. Wizkid is not an upcoming artist. They're big people. But as much as you might have wanted him to suck you know, kiss Beyonce's ass, which, you know, she's probably the best performer alive right now.
Yes.
He has every right to feel aggrieved by something she might have done. She's not perfect.
Yeah.
And I do give him kudos that he gave her respect because he did not say
anything. If it was anyone else, you know, he held back.
But you don't want to held back. Yeah.
About the album itself, how do you feel about the album? You still enjoying it?
I enjoy the album, man.
I have a confession to make. Time flies.
It's a beautiful song.
I started enjoying it.
Yeah, Yusef. I love it.
I'm talking about Time Flies, not the first one.
Time Flies with Sorty Soul.
Yeah, the one that I said was corny.
Thinking of Level Up, yeah.
I'm still listening to it. Like now, the whole... there are no songs that I skip now.
Yeah.
The whole album.
Even Wonderful, like, listen to it again. But
Wonderful, yeah. I started having a new appreciation for Wonderful.
Yeah.
It's weird because I got tired of Wonderful.
It's a
I'm starting to enjoy Wonderful again. In fact, now I actually went back to...
It's a beautiful
...to
album.
Really watch the video. Did you get to see the video?
Yeah, I saw it.
It's a very good video.
It's a good album.
Let's move on to another artist. What do you think? Tiwa Savage is dropping 28th this Friday.
Yeah.
What do you think? I think it's called Silly Abby.
Something like that, yeah. She was on Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah, let me play a clip of that. This Burnout is Afrobeats.
Which one was she on? Burnout was on one of them.
Making her U.S. TV debut. Kimmel, right? Here is Nigerian superstar Tiwa Savage.
Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah, Fallon. Okay, Burnout was on Kimmel.
And it was a nice video too. Like she put a nice video together.
I mean, she's the biggest female artist in Africa, though.
Technically,
there's no technicality. It's her
in Africa.
Yeah,
Africa.
Who's bigger than her in Africa?
Really? Africa?
Who's bigger than that in Africa?
Huh. You may be right. But look at those visuals, man.
Yeah. Wait, and she's started to own up.
Wait, and then this was just a clip she did for this show, right? Yeah, this isn't the original video.
This is just
video.
For the show. Have you seen Burna's performance on... he did it in the garage.
I haven't seen it.
In the parking lot. For, they're doing well now, and I love this. I love the creativity now. And I think they're all upping themselves. I think they're all seeing, you know.
I wish I could show them.
You just put it on the. I'll put it on. They're all seeing what, like, you know, the rest of them are doing.
and they're all like, yo, I'm just gonna up it up, and the quality is increasing, the performances, I mean, look is looking at quality. This. Yeah, which other African artist?
I'm like,
female African artist is gonna give you this quality.
So what do you know of this song?
This is she dropped this. Fuck. So it's a new song that she dropped. Starts with a K, I think. Oh, the album is Koroba. Yeah.
Is this the Koroba? No, this is not Koroba. I heard Koroba. Koroba is
might be Dangerous Love.
Koroba is the one that she did like a challenge for.
This might be Dangerous Love.
Yeah, Dangerous Love. You're right. Yeah, Dangerous Love.
Well, the album she has she has a song with Sam Smith. On the album.
She Temptation, does. Yeah. Oh yeah, I think I saw Sam Smith
put out like a tweet or something. Steph London, Davido.
I saw her in the studio with Naira Marley too.
Hamza, I don't know who Hamza is. Yeah, this is Dangerous Love. Yeah. This is the one where she had like the cover was like that old Sugar thing. But it's amazing.
Yeah, man. So Celia is dropping.
She's finally owning up to that. She's like I didn't used to like Tiwa because when she first moved to Nigeria, she made this interview that was so cringy for me. She was like, she called herself the African Beyonce, Tiyonce. And that thing just made me want to puke. But she's grown into herself.
Yeah.
She's I'm glad she's no longer on Wizkid's pee. Like she was almost like she was riding Wizkid's
coattails at one point.
And I think she self kind of noticed it wasn't really helping her career in terms of, you know,
this is a beautiful song, man.
But she's trying to own herself up as, and then also she's being managed by Roc Nation. They're probably packaging her to fit the bill. And she has the looks. She can dress. She can carry herself.
Some people feel like so one of the more common criticisms I hear of Tiwa Savage is that she's not a good live performer. That's what I hear.
She tries to.
Wait. Is that a study in your ear?
Oh, yeah, it's real.
Baby boy live. Baby boy live. Yeah, I don't know if you guys can see it. This nigga got a stud in his ear. Baby boy live. All right, no, let's get back to what we're saying. I've never seen. Have you seen a performance of hers live?
No, the closest I got to was One Africa Fest in New York, and I kind of it was alright.
Yeah, so that's what I heard. I can't speak to how true that is because I've never been at one of her live performances, but I heard that her voice is not as they say she has studio voice. Is the allegation?
I think she tried. Also, when she performs, I think she tries to look. I think I don't like keep name dropping, but I think she tries to be like Beyonce, Beyonce does a lot of performance, like she dances, she does all these things. But like Beyonce is a performer; she's naturally born talented performer, so she knows how to do both. Tiwa tries to do a lot of dancing, all those stuff, and I think that I don't think she knows how to perfect doing that and singing at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe it doesn't come out as nice as it should be.
Yeah.
But you know, I like her rebranding, you know, and I'm glad when artists rebrand. You know, also another artist I gave shout out to for rebranding was Adekunle Gold, who also dropped this project, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I like when artists actually revamp, look at where they're lacking and change things, and I think she has. I think she's finally doing it, and I'm pretty sure.
So this is the Koroba. She has like a challenge out. I feel like the challenge thing is played out, but this is what Koroba sounds like, Sha.
Oh yeah, this is Koroba. I know from this life
to suffer. If I follow, she has a challenge on Instagram.
Yeah, the challenges are like the easiest ways to get to trend.
But this Koroba song sounds like something. It sounds like copy and paste. I love that Dangerous Love track, but Koroba, I like it. It's a nice song, but I just feel like it sounds like I've heard different variations of
it. No, is that Curse of the curse of the Afrobeats market.
Chasing that sound, chasing the popular sound.
You gotta dance and you gotta, I don't know, man.
Yeah, but I love that Dangerously in Love song. And song. I think the Celia album, I think it should be a good album. I'm looking forward to it.
To be honest,
it's been a while since I heard a Tiwa Savage album.
I think
so.
Tiwa should stick to the likes of Dangerous Love.
Okay.
I think Burner's always stuck to himself. I think Smile by Wizkid is an amazing song.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Cool Me Down.
Yeah, the one with her.
With her, yeah. It's an amazing song. Yeah. I think they should all stick to their strong suit. Leave the dance songs for Naira Marley
and the youngins.
Because here's why I say that. If more of them, and I think I mentioned it before, if more of them stick to their original sound,
yeah,
there'll be bigger diversity. And also, the fan base will be also diverse because the fans are used to one type of sound.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if all your favorite artists are singing different types of sounds, eventually you yourself will mature in your music choices and be like, okay, you know, I fuck with this R&B vibe. It's not every time you're looking for a Zanku song.
Yeah.
But if she keeps giving us Zanku songs, you know, and everybody keeps giving us Zanku songs,
mm-hmm.
then that's what Nigeria Afrobeats would always be about, the drums and the fast up tempo and the pom pom sound. And
yeah,
it's getting played out, man. We need to grow.
One more Afrobeat artist that I felt like we left out on our list, on our chart. So I know we had talked about, you know, Three Headed Monster, Davido, Burna, Wiz.
Who else?
Next tier. Obviously, we have other artists like Mr.
Next
Easy.
Yeah, put Mr. Easy.
Yeah, Mr. Easy. You also have people like Tiwa Savage. That
like,
we
I can put Tiwa in the category.
Yeah, there's some people that we know that, okay, these people, they've proven themselves.
Yes, they're in their own lane.
Someone that we did leave out, and I felt bad for, was Worldy.
Well,
even though I feel like he's more of like an R&B.
Isn't it World?
Oh, I call him Worldy. World. Because he capitalizes
yeah,
the
D-Y. Yeah, I think it's World.
World?
World. As not, so we that list was not just about talent, and I think maybe we should have put him with people to watch out for.
Yeah,
with the likes of Omalay.
Okay, so you don't think he's fully proven himself yet?
No, he hasn't.
You don't think he's been consistent enough? The last album was nice too, the Afro Soul joint.
Yeah, but. The
and I
album,
think he's trying to coin that Afro
the
soul
album,
as his, like, sound.
But it didn't do as nice as the Trouble album.
No, it didn't.
You know,
it didn't.
I feel like that Trouble album definitely got a lot of people thinking and liking World. I love World. I've discovered World when he did the song with Sheezy, Show You Off. You know, this is years ago. So I've been a fan of him since then. I think his music. I listen to that Trouble album while I'm working. Like, it's an amazing album.
It's lovely. It's an awesome album.
You know, I still think I'll put him under those to watch.
Okay.
Even though he has more body of work than the other people on there.
He does.
But
He's dropped three EPs.
Maybe
he's now,
just
right? Yeah.
Promo. He's not getting enough promo.
He also did mention that the industry was kind of against him. I don't know if I told you about the interview that he did with this podcast. It was not a podcast. This
keep talking, honestly. I think we have comments.
We do? Yeah, check him out. Guruba. Is that Farouk? Farouk, we see you.
I think he left.
Oh, he did? Okay.
I don't know, but it said he said they're global, man. Okay. They are global stars, man.
Yeah, they're global stars. So yeah, so we left our World. I think he's someone to still watch. I think he's highly talented. He's probably one of the more talented of the bunch. I was talking about an interview that he did with this guy called Joey Akan.
Joey Akan is a music guy.
Yeah, he's
a music
an
writer,
journalist. Think, yeah. Really, really, really great writer, by the way. Is.
He's not biased to, you know, I think he tries to not be.
He's very direct, even with his interviews. And in the interview, Wald had talked about how, and I don't know if I mentioned it on this podcast already, but he had talked about how the industry in Nigeria kind of felt threatened by him. And that after he dropped Trouble, that it was almost like he felt this different, and I wish I could find the interview so I could actually read out the words, but he felt this different vibe from some of the people that he had worked with, where it was like they wouldn't want, they weren't really as willing to work with him. And the way he explained it was like that whole atmosphere in Nigeria, they're very, very toxic, very dog eat dog.
But that's the whole industry is toxic. Like, even here, everywhere, music, entertainment industry is the most toxic industry. You see people being, I mean, we're going to get to the allegations of, you know, Tory and people like that. We're going to get to all these. Even Nicki and Cardi, all these beefs. You see one day they're friends, the other day they're fighting, they hate each other. This industry is entertainment industry is a very, 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 very shady industry. And I can see why people will be jealous of world, but it doesn't make sense. Like, you can all grow together, man. Like,
you would think
they can all grow together, but...
Another artist that I feel like we might have left off.
Who?
Tenny. Or do you think we left off? Or do you think she should have been left off?
I think Tenny should have been left off.
Tell me about it.
No disrespect to Tenny, but was it 2 years ago when we did our list?
Yeah, had Tenny in there. She made our list.
But since then, what's the last song she sang that made sense since then?
Let me see.
After Billionaire. Because this was before she dropped Billionaire.
She had the Isolate song, which wasn't bad. I mean, it wasn't a smash, but it wasn't a bad song. You know, it did okay on the charts.
You know, this industry, you're only as good as your last song.
You are.
So
it's not easy. See how we're. Do you know how much work these artists put in their craft?
And I try not to be disrespectful to them.
Yeah.
By not saying someone is trash, someone is this. I mean, there's some people that
We are definitely not calling anyone trash.
I don't
trash.
Like some people, but they are. Even I don't like Yemi Alade, but I always give her props in terms of her. She has a good fan base and people love her music.
Yeah. We are definitely not calling anyone trash.
I won't
trash.
Think she should. But I would say, based on the hype I gave Tenny as a writer, as an artist, I think, you know, and I told you, I said the next year was going to be a big year for her. Mm. She didn't do anything until she dropped Billionaire, which was a huge smash.
Yeah.
And then she kind of went cold again. And
sometimes I feel like she goes cold on purpose. Because she's also very
talented.
She's
been dropping since then.
She has? Are you sure?
I think she has. Though. Did she say she dropped?
I know she dropped Isolate. I remember Isolate, and we played that on here. And that was the song that she dropped, like, in the peak of Corona.
But I think she's... Look, like I said, this music industry... Like you said, this music industry is... She dropped one Power Rangers song, which I didn't like.
Oh, yeah, she did. She also dropped that, which did well. But I don't know why it just feels like...
Your Body... Oh, no, that's not her song. It's featuring... someone featuring her.
She's not on the top 100 right dropped. Now though, yeah, she's I'm not. Looking at
but I tell you, but
there.
Let me tell you something though. Like I said, this industry is fickle. Like I've sat here, you and I have sat here, and I keep having to give, and I like to give props where props is due. We've sat here to criticize Adekunle Gold.
Yeah.
We've sat here to tell you that, bro, I'm tired of these guys beggy songs and do this one for me, God, do that one, or this girl chase me. But he's sweet. This guy's confidence. He's sweet. You ever seen his swag now? The guy got his hair braided, got the chest out, everything. And the music, he's like, you can tell my man's confident. And the music follows that confidence. And his music has been good. I've not yet listened to his project, but I'm pretty sure it'll be nice because the three songs he's dropped, you know, this guy got me thinking changing my name to AG Baby, man. Because, you know, my last name starts with AG, you know, but... It's just what it is. So tomorrow, Tenny can actually drop a song that shuts me up and says, hey, she's still relevant.
So I think what she's missing is a body of work that we know that she is. You know, album.
She is. But it's hard. Because you see why it's hard is Fireboy 2 dropped. Mm-hmm. And the first interaction for you to do is to compare it to his last album. But this is a little different from his last album. I like this album too. I like this album so far. But I do prefer the last album. But I like this album so far. Same thing with Burner. People compare this album straight to African Giant. Yeah. And if you do that, you're going to hate this album.
You know someone else that we left off the list?
I don't think I left anybody off.
Your girl, Copy.
All right. So I've been seeing tweets about her. So I've intentionally not listened to her. Jollof. This song is actually not bad.
It's not bad.
I'm not gonna lie. Jollof on the I'm not gonna lie. The beat is nice. But
wait, I don't know how she got that remix.
But this is what she's done that I love. I'm not gonna lie.
Jollof on the jet. I can't believe I know Jollof on the jet. Like, when I saw the video shoot, I was like, this one.
DJ Coffee is not going anywhere. But you know what? She's not going anywhere. Hold on. She's like, I don't care.
Let me hear the chorus. Jollof on the jet. Pause it. But you see what?
Jollof on the jet.
I don't remember if I said it on this podcast, but I said, I think. Copy. Maybe I said it here. I said it to somebody, but I said when Copy was doing those useless songs, they were useless. I said, and I will say it to my chest, even to our face. But I said, I think Copy should do like Khalid, just drop sound bites in songs. Yeah. You know, don't really be the main.
Don't try to be the artist.
But put your name on it. Mm. And because she did well with that song with Kwesi, is it Kwesi Arthur? The search for it. The Copy and Kwesi. I think Zlatan was on it too. No, who was on that song?
I don't know.
Abena, yeah. Kwesi Arthur. Shady was one on it. Just search for Abena. Copy.
Oh, okay. I just saw it now.
Yeah.
Jollof on the Jets. The Copy.
Featuring Kwesi Arthur. That guy's amazing too. That's another guy. He's Ghanaian. He can sing, bro.
She just dropped the album?
Yeah, she dropped an album, yeah. That's Jollof on it. He has Wyclef Jean.
Oh, I need to listen
to this song. It's, the name of the song is Wale. I have to listen to this song. She must have sung this song for me.
A lot of her songs are on the chart, yeah.
Yeah, Bruce, she has a song with Tenny. I need to listen to that too. Okay, you know what? I'm going to listen to her album on the way home because I feel like maybe Copy is like, bro, y'all niggas need to shut the fuck up.
Yo.
Well, go to the Abena song. Man.
Abena, right? Yeah. Let me see. Oh, I think Abena was the one that she had dropped a while ago, right?
Yeah, before she dropped the album. Before she dropped the album, yeah. Okay, this was 2 years ago, so. Abena. I think this was like 2 years ago.
This one says, it's been King Promise.
Yeah, Kwesi. Doesn't it say?
Okay, I see it now.
Yeah. Is King Promise on there too?
No. That was another song.
Yeah.
Press
this. Yeah, this is it. See, she's not really singing. She's just. Yeah, so I mean, yeah, you don't have to play the whole thing, bro.
I just wanted to get to the chorus. Nobody else will love her. But she said, make her wait on top of me. 2 years?
I think it's been 2 years or a year. I think it came out 20. Yeah. So you see, like, just leave the singing to the. See, that's all she has to do. Why you say make her wait? Do DJ Khaled. DJ Khaled cannot sing.
Abena.
Yeah, Jigel, just leave the singing to the professionals.
Yeah.
And just put your copy, your Tetola's daughter. Your name carries power. Mm-hmm. So I like this. And I'm going to listen to the album. It's probably going to be nice.
I like the Jollof.
I like Jollof on the jet. Because when she was shooting the video, I was like, what the fuck is this? I was like, oh my God, I'm going to hate this. But then randomly, I'm listening to a playlist and Jollof on the jet comes up. And I didn't even know it was Jollof on the jet. Because I was like, okay, this song is nice. And then I heard Jollof on the jet. I was like, oh my God. Did she just trick me? But yeah, I think that's what she needs to do.
Yeah.
Just, you know, get this artist that actually talented. Let them make the music.
Yeah.
You just put your little input in there. Curate the whole thing together and put it out there, man. You're going to be topping the charts. But as far as you being the main artist, forget about it, man.
Let's switch to... I want to hit on this Meg topic real quick. So there's been an update with the Megan the Stallion Tory Lanez shooting saga. / we don't know what the heck happened, but there's been an update. And I remember when we brought it up a few weeks ago, we were like, something happened. The video was weird.
The video was Meg getting a police pulling them over.
Yeah, pulling her over, getting out of the car.
The report came out that they were arrested.
Yeah. So now a lot has happened since then. You know, the WAP video has dropped.
Of course.
You know, obviously now we see why there was some kind of associated show with her and really Kylie.
Like, some people don't really like
Kylie WAP, Jenner. Don't let me get in my grandpa bag right now.
I think it's messing up the culture.
That video has dropped. So she had a number. They have a number one single. It's a very, very successful song.
Congrats to them.
She was in the.
Did you see Cardi B singing "When Jesus Is"? Yes, nobody can say. Oh, no, she was singing it when to the haters. You know, probably to you. You know, it's possible.
Hey. So the WAP video dropped.
Yeah.
Then. I think she's been celebrating because it's a big deal. I know that number one album. This is her second number one album in a few weeks. She had that
Savage
one with, yeah,
with Beyonce.
With Beyonce, yeah. And there was a video of her.
She's getting amazing features, man.
In the strip club, at the strip club.
Okay.
And she was, I don't know if she was twerking. I know someone was twerking in front of her, and she was like having fun. She was, yeah, you know, doing her thing. So people started casting doubt, like, ah, isn't this the same person that they just recently shot? What's going on here?
Okay.
That was how it started, you know. Yeah. So I think those
Could you see her full body? Like, was there, like, bandages on her leg or cast?
No,
or?
There were no bandages, but she was in the club. And I guess some people would just think, if you just got shot, why are you even in the club anyways? Okay. You know what I'm saying?
And were we sure that was a recent video?
It was a recent video. Okay. But even though, so I don't think there's anything wrong with her being in the club.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
even if she just recently got shot, yeah, as long as she's not doing like any major physical activity.
I'm trying to see why they are bringing up the video, but go on.
So it was just one of those things that came up.
Okay.
And I think as a reaction to it, she was pissed. She was like, people that are actually, you know, casting doubt on the fact that I may have gotten shot. Now, keep in mind, in her first rant.
Oh, I didn't. So it wasn't Tory's team that said anything?
No, it wasn't Tory's team. It was just different people.
Okay.
Now, she's attributing it to, because blogs carry these things.
Of course.
And she's attributing it to Tory's team. Like,
of course.
You know, what they do is, and they do it a lot in the music industry. Their publicists put out, like, rumors, and sometimes it's like just false allegations.
They put it out. To they so send it out themselves.
Yeah. So, but we don't know if it was really Tory's team, but it could have been either which ways. But she felt like Tory's team was pushing out this narrative out there
about her
faking whatever happened that night.
That's right.
And keep in mind, in her first rant, Megan Thee Stallion, she never directly pointed to Tory being the shooter. She just said, "I was shot." She just said, "I was
sticking to that story."
She's been sticking to that story,
but never name dropped.
She never name dropped
until now.
And keep in mind, when she got arrested, I don't think she told the cops that she got shot.
No,
the way the cops classified it was that was an injury to the glass or something like that.
Broken glass cut her leg. Yeah,
she
might have been grazed. Also,
it could have been anything.
No, I mean, I'm just saying that even if she was shot, it might have been a graze. It might have not.
It might have been
gone through and through, or
it might have been.
It might have not been.
It might have been because there have been a lot of internet sleuths that have been going around looking at. Oh, this is what a short leg should look like, and there's all these pictures of like.
You
just never know.
You never know. It could have been a graze, and that can look like glass cut your leg. Yeah.
Yeah, but she got pissed, and she put out this video the other day because I think she had it. Okay, so this was the video of her in the strip club. You see her? That's all it is. She's not like dancing or anything. But they're saying apparently people were mad that despite being shot, Meg Thee Stallion was still living her best life.
Is she supposed to be crying or or in a sick bed? Like, come
and
on.
Then she got mad, and then she put out this particular video, which is the one that, one second. Abena.
About it, yes, this nigga Tory shot me.
That's right.
You shot me, and you got your publicists and your people going to these blogs lying and shit. Stop lying.
Yeah, that's what I hit too. It was less but not hit.
Why lie? I don't understand. I tried to keep the situation off the internet, but you dragging it. You really fucking dragging it.
Okay.
Motherfuckers talking about I hit this nigga. I never hit you.
Yeah, so now she's just naming him.
Motherfuckers was like,
yeah, man.
She's pissed.
Oh, she mad because he's trying to fuck
different,
with Kylie.
Doesn't she?
No, I wasn't.
Like, I'm not going to talk about that, man.
So
I'm not scared, but.
You scared, nigga.
I ain't got nothing to say.
Everybody
bro.
In the car? It's only four motherfuckers
look.
In the car. Me,
so
you.
She's saying she's trying to protect
my homegirl and your security. Everybody in the car arguing. Mm-hmm. I'm in the front seat. This nigga in the back seat.
Okay.
That's right.
I get out the car. I'm done arguing. I don't want to argue no more. I get out. I'm walking away. This nigga from out the backseat of the car started shooting me. You shot me.
That's right.
I ain't get cut by no glass, but let me tell you why they saying that. When the police, because the people in the neighborhood, there's a witness. When the police came, because the neighbors called the police, this did not happen at Kylie's house. This happened damn near back at the house I was staying at. I was just trying to get home. We was 5 minutes away from my spot. The police come. I'm scared. All this shit going on with the police. The police is shooting motherfuckers for anything. The police was literally killing black people for no motherfucking reason.
See, now that's the
part
that...
As soon as the police tell us all get out the motherfucking car, the police is really aggressive. You think I'm about to tell the police that we, niggas, us black people, got a gun in the car? You want me to tell the laws that we got a gun in the car so they can shoot all of us up? Nigga, I'm scared. It's a fucking helicopter.
I already heard the whole thing.
And some more shit. Why the fuck would...
So that's what she's saying. She's saying that the only reason why she didn't want to, at least correct me, it's what it sounds like, is the reason why she didn't want to point to Tory or to say that there were guns there while the police was there was she was scared that the police would start shooting at them.
Yes.
Because of all the BLM stuff going on. It's, and that she, it was, basically she's trying to say that she was.
Logical explanation?
She's trying to, you it's logical, to me it's not.
Why?
Because I feel like people only use this BLM stuff whenever it's convenient for them. Now, I'm not saying she's lying. And you're right. It could be, to you, it's logical, and she could be telling the truth. But that, you see, that's where, for me, it's like, okay, this is starting to sound a little bit inconsistent.
I can get pulled over by the cops right now and be scared that this is my last day on earth. And you can get pulled over and be like, okay, well, can they just hurry up so I can go? It doesn't mean either one of us is right, but it's just how we react to certain situations. So... I mean, I do feel like...
So, but my question is, why even after the whole, after they might have the whole arrest standoff happened, why couldn't she just still say, well, yeah, this guy shot me?
Maybe she did. Like, maybe legally, you know, they're going to be... can't talk about it. They're going to press charges.
But the police report does not say that she...
Police report says glass. Police report is what you tell them. And if it wasn't, that's why I said maybe she was grazed. Because if it wasn't something where the bullet was still in her leg and she's bleeding out, even though I don't think...
Now, another thing that's inconsistent about her story.
And again, I'm not saying she was walking out and then she was back inside the car.
Is that the police found them, she was inside the car.
Yeah.
Now, she's saying that she was outside when she got shot, right? But that means she must have gone back inside the car.
This is what I think happened.
Isn't that... But don't you think that's strange?
No, it's not. Because it's what I think happened. I do think... Obviously, just kind of like with the whole Deban story.
Okay.
Where I told you from the jump that girl definitely left out a lot of stuff in the story. Mm-hmm. But the bottom line of the story was, no matter what she left out, was that Deban did something to her. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you leave these things out just because you don't want people picking sides or concluding or dismissing your story. Same thing with this. I do think they had a fight.
Okay.
I believe it was not just casual. Because she's denying that... You know, it's not because of, it might not be because of Kylie or whatever. I think they were dating, like people say, and I think they had a misunderstanding. Mm-hmm. They're a very toxic type of people in this world where when they have misunderstandings, they are very, very violent and they say shit and they do all sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. And it's possible they both of them are like that. And I think she stormed out of the car because she's almost home and saying, you know, I'm just going to walk my ass home.
Yeah, she said she was 5 minutes
home. Which sounds very plausible.
Yes.
Tory... On the other hand, same thing with when you hear the Rihanna, Chris Brown thing. I think that's what Rihanna was trying to get out the car at some point. I think that was like the rumor then. When they were fighting, I think she was going to leave the, just walk. It happens a lot. Mm-hmm. Tory probably reached out of anger and maybe tried to fire
warning shots. See, that was what I was thinking.
Which is probably, it's a very stupid thing to do.
Yeah, it's still wrong, you know, regardless.
But he was probably trying to fire a warning shot.
But then she got back in the car.
And then one of them probably grazed her leg.
Okay.
He might not be the sharpshooter or a ricochet or something and he grazed her leg. Mm-hmm. And she's like, what the fuck? You shot me. Mm-hmm. This is all hypothetical. I'm just my theory.
Okay.
And obviously, out of the panic, because it was not intentional, let's take you to the hospital. Now, when the shots were fired, she said a neighbor heard the gunshot. So the neighbor is the one who called police. Mm. So the neighbor heard the gunshots and because obviously they must have been in a nice neighborhood.
Yeah,
you know, she's Meg. She has money. Where she's staying is probably upscale white neighborhood. And then niggas are like, oh, we're hearing gunshots here. So they definitely called the police. And neighborhood's like that. Police answer quick.
So possibly they knew the car. It was, you know, probably described SUV, and police pulled them over on the way to the hospital. Now, getting pulled over.
I like your imagination, but it's very,
because I can see it happening. Okay. I don't think, and the only reason why I would say accidentally he shot her is because I think it's stupid for someone to shoot at you intentionally trying to, trying to kill you, and then you get in the car back.
Yeah, that doesn't add up. That to me is so the part I do that think, really
I do think, even if he was, but I'm not justifying him. I'll get to what I think about Tory, but I'm just trying to fill in the gaps in the story. Mm-hmm. Is one, I think they were fighting. She left, said, I'm going to walk home. He was stupid to grab his gun and fire warning shots or to scare whatever. He grazed her with one of the bullets. And, you know, now he's panicking. Get into the car. Let's go to hospital. And, you know, in the process, they get pulled over because one of their neighbors already heard the gunshots, called the police. And at this point, she's scared. Or they're scared that, man, or maybe Tori's saying, yo, I'm not supposed to have this guy. I can go to jail.
So
now at that point, it's, you know, we got a cover up for you. And we'll deal with that later. Okay. So the cover up is, you know, because we know how bad this can go. She might have not been worried that they will shoot or kill them, but she might have been worried.
Her, literally.
That's why I said I think it might have been a graze. Because I don't, if that bullet went through and through or stuck in her leg, there and there, they're calling an ambulance to come and pick her up there and there. She'll be bleeding like crazy. That's why I think it was a graze. But let's just go on with that. So now she's in the car, bleeding leg, you know, and she's probably not thinking that police is going to shoot me, you know, but she's probably more thinking we got to cover up for Tory.
Okay.
And also we don't need to get searched because there's probably stuff in this car, which ended up still happening.
Yeah.
Because they still searched the car.
They're going to search the car.
And they found, obviously, because, you know, they found a gun. So now Tory gets arrested for that.
And we still haven't heard from Tory. What?
That's what I'm saying. So now here's the...
You have been accused of shooting somebody.
That's why I said I believe it happened. Now here's the issue now. So they're different. Tory could go to jail, but I don't know how Cali is with their gun laws. But Tory could go to jail for a long time. He could be deported and banned from America for a few years. A lot of could happen to him. So obviously...
That'll fuck up his bag too.
So obviously the beginning, it's a case of... Guy, we got to cover you up based on...
Middle song, though.
Yeah, based on your celeb, and this thing can go south. Uh-huh. And, you know, but I think... So that's why she sold the initial story.
Yeah.
Let's say glass broke, whatever. But then, obviously, TMZ picks it up, says they were arrested. So the story now has to come out as to she wasn't arrested.
Mm-hmm.
She was shot. And the reason I think it was Tory is because she could easily said anybody else's name.
Well, it was only four of them in the car, according to her.
So she could have easily said any of the other people that are not famous name. I mean, non-famous, when celebs get pulled over with guns in the car, they throw that against somebody else or weed or stuff. They name somebody. Somebody else takes the fall.
I mean, what kind of drugs could you have been doing?
I don't think he was doing drugs. I think he's a very toxic person I think he's just a toxic person in terms of that.
For me, it still doesn't.
But
none of it makes any sense.
Now the truth will come out, but I do think that it is weird that he's not made a statement because I do think there are legal repercussions to this thing. I think she releasing that video was out of anger. I think it was just pure anger. I don't think she was supposed to do that, but now she's done that, and I also believe, like you brought up, similarity to Justice Smollett.
Yeah.
But I said with the Justice Smollett case, he made up. I can go down the street and say I was attacked by unknown assailants, and it's up to you to figure out the unknown assailants. But if I go down the street and say, yo, Corey shot me, I'm name dropping you. This is different now.
Yeah.
I've given them a suspect. It's different. I feel like it's very hard for her to claim.
It's a serious allegation
because if this is wrong, then the person's carried out taking a hit is Meg.
Yeah.
But now here's the issue I have with people on social media.
Now they're Meg has come about snitching, out. Right?
Meg has come. Yeah, so there are two issues I have.
Mm-hmm.
Issue number one is, you say she snitched. I think that is BS because this girl is venting.
We need to end this snitching. This whole snitching thing is like, campaign.
Bro, she's venting her pain, her problems, and she needs to clear everything out. It's nothing called, you saying the truth is not snitching. You guys are not from the streets. And snitching, not snitching, has put so many people in trouble. So she has to clear herself. Second thing I don't like is from the other side, the women. The women that have now taken this to be saying stuff like, oh, if another black man dies, I'm never protesting because black men are the devil. Black men need to do this. Black men need to do that. Oh, this, that. So you guys are going to negate the whole Black Lives Matter movement we've all done and the protest and everything because Tory Lanez shot at Meg Thee Stallion? So your mentality now is, where if another black man dies, because you do understand that when that police officer that you guys are protesting for, that you say kill black people, he's not going out to kill just black men.
Yeah.
When a black man dies, it's not a black man dies we're protesting for. We're protesting that a black person dies. But if you're going to now start saying stuff like, oh, if a black man dies, I'm never going to protest again. I'm not going to do it. It's a very toxic way of thinking, because now you're stupid enough to be like, well, it's a gender thing. Only we only deal with black men, because they're saying black men, black women, black men are the weakest link, this and that and that and that and that. Like, it's a very, very, very toxic mentality to have. Yes, you can feel like Tory messed up. I don't think anybody feels like Tory shooting Meg was right. I think everybody agrees that Tory shooting Meg, if really, 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 which I think is what happened, but if really, really, really that's what happened, I agree that Tory shooting Meg is a bad thing that Tory shot Meg, you know, if that's really what happened. But I don't think it's enough justification for me to then say, well, if another black man gets shot or whatever, I'm not going to protest, if you really do believe in Black Lives Matter, because it doesn't say black men's life matter or black women's life matter. It's Black Lives Matter. So that aspect I'm not a fan of. And also the aspect of people saying Meg snitch. What the fuck is this code you guys are keep going on about?
Makes no sense.
It makes no sense. That girl had to come out and say what she feels is the truth. Why should she keep quiet anymore if she feels like, man, keeping quiet isn't doing anything? I have to say what's on my mind. And then you guys say, you are the same people that were out there asking her to say, who shot you? Who shot you? Who shot you? Then she drops his name. She's like, oh, dang, she snitched.
Makes no sense.
Makes no sense. It's a stupid code. It makes no sense.
But we're due for a break right now.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, like, look, I just feel like, you know, the truth will come out. And I feel for Meg. I do believe her story. I feel for her. What's that?
Did you hear that?
Yeah, what was that?
You want to do it again?
No, don't do it again.
Yo, whenever there's a murder mystery, that's what I press. Yeah,
but I feel for her, and I do feel like you guys started with this soundbite again.
Oh, I got applause out here.
Guy, play this thing, bro. All
right. So,
but you know, we'll find out 100% truth in no time, man.
We sure will.
You've seen that a lot of women have started taking off Tory from their songs, their future upcoming songs.
From albums, right?
Who I saw like two women. I can't remember their name. I mean, hey, man, I have no issues with that, man. I mean, dude, if you're shooting at somebody, if you're shooting at somebody, you deserve everything that comes at you.
Yeah, that's from wild.
As a result of that.
That's a wild allegation to have.
Yeah.
That you shot the person that you were messing with.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Can you introduce the song for us?
It's called, give me my phone again. It's called
In My Maserati.
I forgot the artist's name. It's a song it's by Alakira. Yeah.
Alakira. Where you be finding these peeps, man?
Yeah, I just find them from somewhere, man.
Alright, well, this is In My Maserati. Alright, yeah. We'll be back in a second.
Yeah. All I get a great at the baby.
You, and that.
Girl, that you the ginger. If you know how you the cause you drop. Shit, you know go in person. Love the way you the dance, girl. I am a magic. Why the kind of fire? Mommy,
where did you get cool?
Let's hop in my Maserati.
Baby boy, I didn't know this
last week. Let's hop in my Maserati.
Okay.
In my Maserati. Girl, I wanna see
you. I remember when I used to have thoughts.
Send me a love the way you been body. Hop in my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati. And I just wanna see you like somebody. Somebody needs somebody. My body, your body. I'm more checker. All I'll be the one. All I'll be you. Somebody. Somebody needs somebody. My body, your body. Let me give you butterfly. Say
energy, they mesmerize me. I'm out to shun to civilize. Anywhere you go, I go follow. When I up the music, make it go low. And I go keep you steady on the slow. Baby, don't dull, make a jingle. Shawty, I know you like to party. I'm out to jump on me. Show my body shape. Yeah, yeah. Baby, come on, God. Innocent nobody, yeah. I'm gonna make you happy. Make you happy. Up in my Maserati. Baby, up in my Maserati. I say up in my Maserati. Up in my Maserati. Girl, I wanna see you go down. Yeah, say me I love the way you bend body. Up in my Maserati. Baby, up in my Maserati. And I just wanna see you ride. Somebody, somebody need somebody. My body, your body, I'm on check out, all of you, all of you. Somebody, somebody needs somebody. My body, your body, I'm on check out, all of you. Up in my Maserati, big love in my Maserati. I say up in my Maserati, up in my Maserati. Girl, I wanna see you go down. Yeah. Say me I love the way you been body. Up in my Maserati. Make love in my massage, and I just wanna see you cry.
Hey, Baco. Ah, man, where do you be finding these songs, man? We should call you DJ. DJ Black G Wagon.
Don't worry, the closing song to Zona. I'm gonna put you guys on to
DJ
song
Black again. G Wagon. I want to play
yeah,
this.
Yeah, shout on our IG live. They told us that it was Doja Cat
took him off.
I don't know whose handle that is, but shout out. I can't remember what it is. Starts with an O, but shout out to you, man.
Oh, okay.
I feel like it's on your call.
It might be.
I don't know. Let me see. But yeah, it says Doja Cat took her out.
They're about to super cancel Tory Lanez. Let's just put it that way. I'm telling you, that guy needs to come out with a statement.
Actually, maybe not.
He needs to come out with a statement. Moving on, real quick, I was going to play this. I thought it was a funny clip. This is Josh Too Funny, and he's remixing. Apparently, it's an old song.
It's not her. It's actually not her. I don't know who it is.
Apparently, it's an old song, but... Sorry, apparently it's an old clip, but this I only heard it like recently. I thought it was funny.
Don't
but
forget to mute the mic this time.
It's Josh
so
Too Funny.
So they can hear it properly.
Yeah. No, I figured we'd talk about it. Right. It's Josh Too Funny remixing one of Roddy Ricch's songs. Do you remember the name of the song?
Ballin.
Now, this is the original version of the song. Let me play it so people know what this song is supposed to sound like.
This guy's a clown. It's his character, Resurrection Power. That's the name of his character.
Yeah.
First of all, I don't know where he gets the suits from, man. Those suits gotta be custom.
We all know this song.
Cause all my niggas got it out the streets. I keep 100 racks inside my jeans. I remember hitting them all with a whole team. Now a nigga can't answer call cause I'm balling. I was waiting.
Alright, so let's check out Josh Too Funny's version. This shit is hilarious. It's like a, supposed to be like a church choir parody.
Resurrection Power.
Resurrection Power.
I wanna drop the bottom underneath. All my people on the street. I put 100 naira inside my jeans.
I go sleep for Doji on that tree. I say when the God comes in my bed. If we for Doji on that tree, it will be balling like a G.
I remember when I come with the whole thing. Everybody on street we are balling.
Check it out. It's on his page.
Resurrection power, I'm pushing.
Oh my god,
cracking when I hear this shit.
He's serious. That's what I know. Like, he has a serious look on his face.
This is one of his worst.
Oh my gosh, that guy! Nah, he cracks me up. He cracks me up.
Not like Justin. He's a case. He's been. He's actually consistent because he started. He's the one that did the whole what's that thing? All my guys are ballers.
Yeah.
Then he's the one who did the obviously don't leave me challenge.
Yeah.
He gets to definitely trend.
Creative man. Creative. He's like a. Okay, so what else happened this week? KOO, Kemi Ololoyan. You know, I always have to. Anyone we talked about on here,
I'm always an investigative journalist in Ibadan. That's how she fucking.
In Ibadan?
In Ibadan. Reporting live from Ibadan.
So.
Kemi Ololoyan.
Look. Davido's baby mama pissed her off. Now, she you know, she's always saying,
I don't like Davido. This is someone that doesn't like Davido, man, because she's always on that nigga's case.
She
especially
is.
When it comes to like baby. She's the one who reported that he has another baby mama.
Yeah.
She when Chima was first pregnant, she was the one crying on her head. Like,
yeah.
She's like, my investigative journalism.
Journalism?
Journalism.
You understand. Oh, but man, anyway, clown, so finally, I think Chima. Eventually, I guess she got fed up.
Yeah, I mean, I don't blame her, man.
If I decide to arrest her for all the things she's been saying about my husband and I,
she's still saying my husband.
Okay, we'll say it's unfair. Okay, be warned that. And Kemi saw that. You know, if you give Kemi any, let me call her Auntie Kemi. If you give Auntie Kemi,
she says she doesn't like Auntie Kemi. She likes Dr. Kemi.
Dr. Kemi.
Reporting live from Ibadan, Nigeria.
Ibadan. Let me give her her props. Anyway, the last thing you want to do is give her any kind of.
That's it, man. That's it.
If you're a celebrity and you give, forget it. She's going to be on you. So she replies and she just goes off.
She got a topic to talk about now.
She's like, I may have forgiven Davido to all of you, but I haven't.
Oh, she didn't even call him David. That's nice.
To all of you, but I haven't forgotten how he insulted me and never said the one simple word for his tweet. Sorry. It was utter disrespect. I don't forgive people. This is just a lie to pacify. This is just a lie to pacify my words into your head. Don't step on my toes. Stay in your lane. Aloma has already done his job. Let sleeping dogs lie. I have more serious things at hand. All your celebrity friends have been begging me for you idiots from Tiwa to Sam Cliff. I repeat, stay on your lane. Your money means nothing. You haven't achieved one damn thing in your life, young lady. Rented a Porsche for your birthday. You can't drive. Broadcasted a cooking show. You can't cook, nor launched it yet. Calling yourself a chef without training. Let me stop. Or if I continue, it will be a bad fall season for you. Oh, man.
Chema is
not
like
your baby daddy's hit song, but September to December 2020 is called fall season in America. I need nobody's feedback. Until someone insults your mother to go oil her pussy in front of 9 million people, you won't understand. Don't ever use innuendos with me. It doesn't work. Davido and Chema, fucking stay on your own lane. God damn.
You know what? At the end of the day, this lady is probably in her 50s, 60s.
Like,
and Chema is like 20 something. Like, come on, man. Sense. Like, grow up. Grow the fuck up, man.
It makes
like,
no sense.
She's like, how do you expect anyone to take you serious as an investigative journalist? When you're going after someone who you can be her mother and, you know, your investigative journalism is gossip. Your journalism is the result of your journalism is something that we can live the rest of our life without knowing the stories you put out.
Of course,
we didn't like when you put
although she be having some exclusives though.
She does,
but it's rumors and gossip.
Yeah, and gossip. It's something that whatever, man. I didn't really care if Chema was pregnant or not or somebody. I don't really care, but I don't know, man. And then you're old. Like, come
she's
on,
an Agbaya.
You're an Agbaya. Like, why
she's
you?
She's an Agbaya. She's an Agbaya.
Like, man, it's like, what is the whole, like, that clap back of you rented a Porsche and live streamer? It's something that a teenager would say, man. Like, come on, man.
But let's talk about Chema, though, talking about arresting people. Now, She probably said that because
Shoma ain't got no power to arrest nobody.
Because Kemi has been arrested before, right?
Shoma has not arrested anybody.
But who was the one that got Achama arrested?
I don't know.
I think she had come after politicians at one point. Yeah, I remember. And she got arrested. She had slandered a politician.
Kemi Onoyo needs to, sorry to cut you. She needs to stop this whole reference to America. Nigga, you were deported, man. That's the rumor. So, like, just
alleged,
drop it.
Alleged
rumor. Just drop it, man.
All alleged.
Just drop it. Like, which one is fall season? Is September to what it's called fall? It's falling all over the goddamn world. Which one is America? About. Like, is that a clap back? Like, what are you trying to? Like, bro, you too old for all that shit. But, yeah, you're right. She has been arrested. Rumor was, I don't know who did it. But
I remember it was for like a few days. And it was like for a while.
I think so. It's like a few days, maybe. I don't really know too much about her story. I only just
I forgot who it was, but it was I think it was some politician she had made allegations against, and they threw her in jail.
Next time I'm in Ibadan, I'm going to record a Snapchat saying reporting live from Ibadan.
But I find it very, very annoying when celebrities make those kind of threats, because that's
arresting people.
Yeah,
especially power, like, powerless celebrities. Chairman, you're not arresting nobody. You ain't got the funds. You ain't got.
I mean, she might use Davido's clout. I
would think they're on good terms.
You don't think so?
That's been. I'm surprised she referred to him as her husband.
They're still. Are they not married?
Let's ask Kemi, man. Kemi would know. Dr. Kemi. Dr. Kemi. I'll be respectful.
Dr. Kemi, a little lawyer
reporting live from the battle.
Uh huh.
Let's ask her. She's, sorry, I don't know.
I hit the wrong one. I meant to hit this one.
I don't know what's going on. The rumor is they are split up, but it's a rumor. I don't know. Rumors. But I mean, yes, she doesn't have any clout. I mean, even a lot of these people, every small thing, I'm going to arrest you. I'm going to sue you. I'm going to get out of here, Joe.
Moving on. Did you see this clip?
What?
It was a clip about how FBI people got Hush Puppy. Did you see it?
I saw that clip, but I don't know how authentic it is. I feel like somebody else just did a voice.
A voiceover?
Because there was an ad at the end of the video.
Really? Well, the caption says, FBI explains how they caught billionaire Nigerian scammer Hush Puppy.
I don't know, because then they had clips from the Dubai arrest.
Yeah.
Then they now had clips from Vice that was just clips of regular, like, episode of Hackers and stuff like that. So, like, I think it's somebody who compiled it together and did a voiceover.
Oh, you think so?
I don't think it's official, because I can't even find it officially on, like, you know, FBI. I searched for it. I searched, you know.
Besides, FBI never puts out.
They never put out. And
but then it could have been a news organization that was just saying this is how FBI.
But then
FBI
there was an ad
him.
At the end of it, too. You'll see the video. But I don't know.
I'll play it. So let me
the video.
Let me
Barry posts on the gram.
We haven't authenticated this by three people, so guys.
They couldn't wait to make some legendary posts on the gram. One such post said, started out my day having sushi down at Nobu in Monte Carlo, Monaco. Then decided to book a helicopter.
Yeah, the voice. Yeah, someone just created Christian
dealer. But it could have been a media company that was just the news special.
Day having champagne and Gucci. Then he proceeded to tag posts with hashtag all mine and stand with a number of Bentleys, Mercedes, Ferraris, and Rolls Royces. But right there for all to see was some very key information. He had his email and phone number saved to his Instagram. And when our boys here at the bureau did a little digging,
really,
we were able to link it to financial transactions and transfers known to be associated with co-conspirators. To quote our affidavit, the email account also contained emails with attachments relating to wire transfers in large dollar values.
One post had
a picture of his birthday cake,
it's weird that
and it had a Fendi logo on top. Our investigators were able to verify his date of birth
obviously not FBI,
from a previous U.S. visa application.
I think it is some media
company
doing it.
We had all we needed. July 2nd, 2020,
we made
our move. Our buddies at the United Arab Emirates.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I don't think this is real.
Nah, because see, they're using clips from that's the same clip.
The Dubai one.
It's not real.
They sent him to us. And now our agents have him secured away at the Metropolitan Correction Center in Chicago. After his arrest, we seized his assets, almost $41 million.
And this is all news that we already knew. So, and if you look, a lot of clips are not even clips of him or the arrest.
$8 million. They got some clips from like TV shows.
Yeah, from TV shows.
Sorry, Ramon. You didn't earn it legally. The next step for Hush Puppy? Well, this cyber criminal will be transferred to Los Angeles. And if he is convicted, he should be put away for a very, very long time.
And this sounds like...
Money laundering is a serious offense. And when it's in the millions of dollars, it's even more serious.
See, that's the ad. DM for prompt. You see that?
Yeah, I don't think...
Yeah, it's somebody just did a voiceover. Somebody put a clip together and got a white guy to
It's got 1.2 million views.
You know Africans be falling for everything.
Interesting. Yeah, that doesn't look... Just looking at it again, that doesn't
every
look...
video. Niggas... Me, I try to authenticate videos before I fall for the hype. But it is what it is, man. I mean, the truth is that he's still in custody, so...
Yeah. Another story that I wanted to quickly touch on was in Mali. Are you familiar with what's going on?
The 25-year-old, supposedly 25-year-old, because that nigga looks like... It's, don't let me call him nigga, because that guy is the army leader. Mm-hmm. They come and find me. But he overthrew the... It's a coup. It was a coup.
Yeah, yeah, there's a coup. And let me play a real quick clip of it. It's...
Some jam.
So this is... Oh, there's no commentary. So there's really no commentary. They arrested him, Sha. The former president. Or the president, right?
Yeah.
They arrested him. He's been in... He's been in office for, what, over 20 years? Or something?
Yeah. Hopefully, you know.
I was hoping you knew, because I don't really know what's going on.
I haven't really
story.
Followed too much. I just saw, you know, I just saw the I just saw the news article about it. I really don't know what's going on.
So it looks like there was a military coup. And now the military is seeking transitional power.
Hopefully, you know, they hand over
coup
to
coup plotters in Mali were trained by US.
Maybe CIA, because CIA...
Could this be one of these
CIA be good at that, man. They be good at that shit. They train you, tell you to take over your country, then they tell you to put over whoever they want in charge. Well, we'll see, Sha. We'll see how that goes out. But I hope they're safe. I hope they do hand over to someone who's, you know... We need to stop this dictatorship in
Okay,
Africa.
So let me read what's going on. This is straight out of Wiki. This is not no professional site. But this looks like... the situation at hand in Mali. Keita, who's the president? His name is President Ibrahim Boubacar Keita. He had been in office since he's often known by his initials IBK. He's a Malian politician who served as president of Mali from September 2013 to August 2020. So it's only been 7 years when he was forced to resign in the 2020 Malian coup d'etat. When he was forced to resign in the 2020 Malian coup d'etat, he served as Mali's prime minister from 1994 to 2000. Oh, that's why it's been that long. So he served as prime minister prior to that and as president of the National Assembly of Mali from September 2002 to 2007. Keita founded the center-left political party RPM in 2001. After a number of unsuccessful campaigns, he was elected president in the 2013 presidential election and re-elected in 2018. He resigned 19th of August 2020 after being taken by captive by mutinous elements of the Malian armed forces. Mm-hmm. This is interesting. So this is another coup d'etat, another leader in an African country that refuses to leave his seat, it seems, it appears. Some additional details. He won the election in a second round of voting, defeating Soumaila Cisse, and was sworn in as president on the 4th of September 2013. Keita vowed to prioritize ability rather than political considerations when appointing ministers, and on 5th of September 2013, he appointed a technocrat, Umar Tatam Lee, as prime minister. After Umar Tatam Lee's resignation, Keita appointed Musa Mara on the 5th of April 2014 to 9th of January 2015, and Modibo Keita. Upon Keita's resignation, Sumeilu Bubeye Maiga was appointed prime minister, blah, blah, but resigned 18th of April amid public protests following the Ogosago massacre. On 22nd of April 2019, President Keita named Bubu Cisse as prime minister.
Your story is boring me.
On 18th of August 2020, Keita and Cisse were arrested by mutinying soldiers in a coup d'etat. The next day, Keita dissolved parliament and announced his resignation, saying he wanted no blood to be spilled to keep him in power. So it sounds like one of these leaders that have been in office. I don't know the specifics, so I can't really give any objective opinion right now. All I know is that this is something worth noting that's happening in Africa. And when it comes to these African dictators, so to speak, you know, I think we have too many of them that are consumed with power. Mm-hmm. What is it about Africa that people never want to leave office? What exactly is it? Well, what is in the water?
Is it to oppress people and take advantage of people? And the people, look at Niger, for instance. I mean, in Niger, we're lucky we have a quote-unquote democracy where people live after. I mean, but even the elections are mostly rigged sometimes.
Yeah.
And nobody really gets held accountable. You know, it's like...
So what would you say about the people that say... And this...
It's the people that let these things happen.
I know. But well, how about the argument that perhaps it's impossible to have real change when you're having all this continuous transitional power? Some people would argue, and I'm not saying it's right. I'm just throwing it out there. Some people would say that the reason why Nigeria it is today is because of... You know, PDP, one time is PDP, right. PDP gets in office, but then they do their dirt, then we switch to APC, then they do their dirt. And then some people, let me finish now, and some people would argue that maybe we need to be more like Rwanda, where we just one party, no options, just a guy that we know that we can trust and that can just run this shit.
We have one party. Because the same people that were in APC now. When PDP comes in power, they're going to move back to PDP. It's the same people in power. So we just have one party, to be honest. But here's the issue. It's so toxic in that country that, you know, Nigerians don't even care for fellow Nigerians. So we don't have people who actually care for each other. Like, it's every man for himself. So even if tomorrow we say we're kicking out the ruling party and a new party coming in, the person coming in too has this mindset that he has been raised with, that Lomo is only for me and my people. So he's going to get there and do what is right for his people. We don't have candidates that actually care. You know, it's almost a dog eat dog world out there. And maybe it's because of being oppressed and the poverty that everybody feels like, man, once it's my turn, I have to eat my national cake, as they call it.
Yeah.
So, but then also, no accountability, you know, and if, to be honest, and that's where Buhari has disappointed me, but then it's hard. He's one man, because you came in with this whole anti-corruption thing, but when your people were corrupt, you looked the other way. When you know, things happen, look at the whole NDDC thing. Nobody's arrested. Nobody's been charged. Nobody's going to go to jail. All somebody had to do was just fake fainting. That's it. It's like, if that dude got arrested and got sent, made the scapegoat, you can't stop embezzlement, but the rate at which these guys embezzle, there's no heart in it. It's different
from embezzlement. The Pundit thing is very is embarrassing. I know we laughed about it, but it's actually sad when you think. It's actually sad.
Let's name all the people.
It's a mockery of
when Fayose was being charged or his trial, whatever his case. What did he do? He came in a hand crutches. Stuff and said crutches. You know, I'm in severe pains, blah, blah, blah. When you look at it, you're like, what the hell? But it's actually a smart plan, because he knew he was going to get away with it, or either he's innocent or not. He didn't even, that was the end of that. Mm-hmm. When Dino Melaye, same thing, he came in with a neck brace, they had to carry him physically, and guess what? He got away with it. Either he was guilty or innocent, we don't even know, but that was the end of that. Same thing with this guy. During the hearing, pretended to pass out. That's the end of it.
Is it possible that maybe democracy is not for us?
Then look at someone like James Ibori, who was sentenced to prison. James Ibori was sentenced to prison in England for money laundering. And let me just make sure. He was a former governor of Delta State. I just want to make sure it's the right. Yeah. He was released from UK jail.
You know, he used to be one of Babangida's hitters.
Oh yeah,
Ibori. Well, allegedly.
So
allegedly,
he was in jail in UK for money laundering or whatever it was. I don't know how many years it spent, but he got released. Guess what? James Ibori lands back in Nigeria to a crowd of people waiting to welcome him back. Is that not a very
sheep mentality. Like, it's a very, like, this guy was convicted for a crime.
So what it sounds like you're saying is that we deserve the leaders we
get. We do deserve the leaders
we get.
Our
leaders are a reflection of
the society we are. Yeah. So this guy was sentenced to jail, and he comes back because you guys know he has money.
So you're saying that democracy is working. It's working for the people that are putting people in power.
We have a democratic system, quote unquote, because we have presidents who maximum would do 8 terms, yeah. 8 years, which is 2 terms, and the other, there's elections, the governorships elections, and we also have, you know, governors who last only 4 years, and you know, it's not automatic for you to be 8 years in power. We have things like that. We have transitions, and we have, you know, we're also getting young governors. I mean, young people in politics and stuff like that. So, to an extent, there is. The only problem is that these people that are coming in, be it old, be it young, most of them have just one mindset.
Yeah.
That mindset is to chop money as much as they can.
And what I'm saying is that it seems like we, the people, keep putting these same people in office. So what I'm asking is that, is democracy working for us the way it should? And maybe it's just the people that just need a change of mindset.
So,
or is democracy not for us and we actually need...
It's for us because it's going to be worse if you have one person. Unless you have Abacha. But then the problem with Abacha is this. Someone like Abacha. Someone like Abacha would... That whole Pondis... That one probably even died by now.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is we saw what Abacha did. As strict as it was, a lot of people are saying, this cannot happen under Abacha's term. This cannot... But Abacha died in 99. We're in 2020. 21 years later, he was still receiving a lot from the money he stole.
Did you hear what his son said?
What?
His son said that the dad was keeping the money for Nigeria.
Okay, nice. Thank you. Tell him he said thank you. But 21 years later, we're still seeing... Was it 99 he died? I think it was 99, yeah.
It was 99 that we switched to a democracy. So when did he die? He died 98 or 99. Yeah.
So he's we still get an alert. Mm-hmm. So he's been the biggest thief in the country that we know of. So even though he had people under his whip, but what was he doing? So the only way that can work is if you have someone who's as strict as that, but does it for good. Does it for good. Which, to be honest, man, all that power, man,
is tricky.
It's very hard. So
no one man should have all that power.
So it's like, yes,
power corrupts.
I'm glad that we have a democratic system, but we have a system that we deserve, and we keep letting these people in, and we keep letting them. I keep mentioning Dino Melaye, and you see all these things he does, but why should someone like Dino have all that money and no one ever, you know, queries him? Instead, you're excited to kiss his ass so that he can give you money, and that's, we deserve it.
The reason why I brought up this Mali story is that this is a military dictatorship. And my fear is that I don't want this to start creeping into...
We're not
going to
have a military dictatorship in Nigeria. We've already had it.
We've had many in the past.
We've had the last one ended. Well, since it ended, we're not having it again.
You don't think so?
I don't think so.
Well, Obasanjo did a good job of defanging the military when he got in office.
Yes.
So
I don't think we're going to have it again. I've thought about it before. Do we need it? I do think people need to revolt.
You think what?
At some point in the past, I thought maybe we need it. Mm-hmm. But I do think the people need to revolt. I do think, even look at when we did Occupy Nigeria protest.
Mm-hmm.
After 2 days, they turned it into a challenge. That's the people we are. They turned
it
into a challenge where people were taking
their
furniture on outside and who can take picture with your furniture on the streets.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, the leaders look at you and so many people are tired, you go back to work, and that's what happened. We're not ready. We're not ready for true leadership. We've accepted it. It's like, well, guy, as long as I can take care of myself, I do okay, nothing else I can do. We've accepted it.
Let's move on to this one last topic I have here, and it's the topic about, I don't know if people heard about it, it was the Netflix poster.
With the kids.
The kids. The movie is called Cuties. There was an original version of the movie which was released in France.
And the poster had the kids. Shopping. They were shopping.
Yeah, they were coming back from shopping. Yeah, they were. It was very, very.
Doing kids' stuff.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. But the movie is about kids, about this girl that comes from like a strict conservative Muslim family.
Obsessed with twerking.
And she gets exposed to these young girls. And these are young girls. They can't be more than 13 years old.
Yeah.
But she gets exposed to this group where that they like these kids are like twerking. The thing about twerking is a kind of a sexually suggestive dance.
It is.
So the movie itself on its own, it's a little bit
it's
weird.
A sick idea.
It's weird. It's but look, it's
creativity.
Art.
It's art.
It's art. So and I don't like to now the promotion of this movie. The promotion of this movie is where it gets a little weird because
in France,
there were kids on the cover. It was just kids. They fully were jumping clothed. Up. Yeah, fully clothed.
They had different layers of clothes on, and they were carrying shopping bags and stuff like that.
And then
in America, the USA,
Netflix puts out a poster for this movie,
the USA version,
and I need to show them on live because this is actually kind of ridiculous.
They're wearing like cheerleader.
This is what it looks like.
Cheerleader. Is anybody on live? This here. For the two people that are on live.
Yeah. Like.
But it's. I think they're wearing like cheerleader outfits, and they're like in suggest. I don't know. It was kind of disgusting.
They took it down. You know, they acted very fast. There was uproar online immediately. But yeah, it was weird. It was weird. It made me a little uncomfortable. Because these are girls that were in like sexually suggestive poses. Now, this brings me to WAP.
Yeah, but WAP is.
Do you see why things like WAP? Do you see why things?
Adults.
Do you
see why grown ass women?
It's all on YouTube.
They are over. It's all on YouTube. The age of 18. It doesn't matter.
It's all on YouTube.
You have the right.
These are girls twerking.
Your kid.
Twerking is becoming normalized with kids now.
Corey, the same child that found WAP video can find pornographic porn herself or himself.
Okay.
So that has nothing to do with it. Either you put WAP out there or not. If that child really wants to find these things, they will find it. It's your job to make sure, even when your child finds it, they understand that this is an adult thing. You're still a kid.
Fair.
Be a child.
Fair. I'm not saying we should censor the video. Like I said before,
God, come on,
Joe. when we celebrate certain things, I'm telling you, it sends a certain message. There's nothing wrong. Look, I've listened to all kinds of lewd content. I told you my very, very first foray into rap was Snoop Dogg's It Ain't No Fun. And it's one of the dirtiest songs that you hear out there. It's a nasty song. And I was a kid. And like I said, I didn't like it necessarily because of what they were saying. Of course, it was lewd. But it's not like I saw people celebrating that kind of lifestyle. Now, things have changed since then. Things have changed tremendously since then. And I know I might sound like a grandpa. I know I don't sound... There's nothing cool about...
When we're growing up and listening to rap music and gangster songs, did you ever once think of carrying a gun and going to kill somebody?
No, because
what's different about you and the kids of today? Why can't they also have the same reaction?
Because
I never once thought about
because I knew that those
shooting
actions,
somebody, robbing somebody.
Because the message, you see, I knew that those actions, right? The message of those actions, I knew I had people.
Well,
to,
you were, you're
I had people. Sort of. I had people. Yeah, I was a kid, but yeah. I had people to tell me that I knew that. Okay,
exactly.
You can't just go kill.
Exactly.
You can't just go
so
kill
don't
people.
Blame,
right.
Blame the people to tell you is the key part.
Yeah, but then if the culture is celebrating something as a symbol of women empowerment.
But there have been songs, Corey.
We're telling people that to twerk and shake your ass and be naked is a sign of empowerment. What kind of message are we trying to send?
It's not about...
How is it empowering?
Sexuality is you expressing yourself in a
sexual way.
Any way is empowerment. Is empowering. You being able to express yourself. That's it. And do you know that we that come from a conservative nation, let me tell you this thing. Do you know that Nigeria is very obsessed with sex?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we are.
I don't watch Big Brother. Mm-hmm. But every time I go on Twitter, is somebody having sex in that house?
Yeah.
Them niggas just went to the house like yesterday and like, I mean, when it first started. And like next day, niggas are fucking each other.
But it's not being celebrated.
Says who?
There's a difference there.
Says who?
It's not being celebrated.
People are looking people are setting up their schedules to watch that shit enjoy it.
Yes, it's a guilty pleasure. And
okay,
we all,
you know
we
why?
All have
do you know why?
It.
Because we suppress.
But to celebrate
but
it as,
you know why?
Oh,
because
this is a symbol of empowerment.
Do you know why?
No one's going to say it's empowering.
We suppress this thing. I remember the stats that Google put out that Nigeria is one of the top countries that search for gay porn.
For gay porn, I know.
There are a lot of politicians out there and models and a lot of people that people say that they're
you don't get the
gay.
Distinction.
So
I'm
what is going on is that yes. So but how is this still happening if they're not celebrating it? Let people be free. Instead, you're keeping it inside. Mothers will tell your daughter at age of 18.
No one is saying
don't
that
let
they
man,
do
don't
the
let a man
video.
Touch you.
No one is
Hold
saying
on,
that
your
they
mother will tell you that
video.
Don't let a man touch you at 18. Then at 25, be asking where's your husband. Between 18 to 25, what's going on in your life there? You've been told that if a man should touch you, you'll be pregnant. Then you've been scared of sex, blah, blah, blah. Until the day one guy finally has sex with you.
Argument.
And you realize that, man, you have a high sex drive. And then you become very sexually active, and in that same society will tell you a hoe.
I get your
Come
argument.
On,
I get your argument. There needs to be
Express
sexual
yourself.
Liberation, right?
Express yourself.
There is
celebrate
right?
expression.
But here's my thing, right? If there was a trend of people being unable to express themselves sexually, if there was this pressure, right? Like in the '90s, America was a little bit more conservative, right? And that was why when people like Lil' Kim came out. Back then, it was new. It wasn't that common to see like a black woman sexually own her. So what I'm saying is that we've already seen the progress. So then it was empowering because back then it was taboo. It's no longer taboo. And the difference that the distinction I'm trying to make here is that it's no longer taboo. Like there's nothing stopping. Wait, let me finish. There's nothing stopping Megan Cardi from showing whatever they want to show, right? I don't think they themselves did anything wrong. That's not what I'm saying.
You're saying people
what
that
I'm saying is that what I'm saying is that when publications like Complex is a huge
Complex wants to trend.
Let me finish now. Complex is a huge kids. There's kids that follow Complex loyally. Like that's something that they gear towards kids a lot.
Okay.
When they start holding it up, when they look at videos where girls aren't really, they're not doing anything, they're not showing anything, and it's just, oh yeah, it's a nice video. But then they now make exception for these videos that are hyper-sexualizing women, right? I'm not saying that they shouldn't be allowed to do it. What I'm saying is that when they hold it up and put it on a pedestal as a sign of empowerment, I'm telling you, man, it's only a matter of time before that's all we see. Because what we're telling you is that, look, this is what it means to be empowered.
And Complex.
It sends the worst message.
It's not Complex's job to raise anybody's child.
Fair.
It's not Complex's job to tell your child what is right or wrong. Complex's job is to promote music and talk about music. And
but it's important for people to also be able to push back against it, too. That's what I'm saying.
You can, and that's your business.
That's all I'm saying.
You can sit here and tell me black is king, we're all kings and queens.
Yeah.
And you can also sit here and say we're all trifling and hoes and everything. That's how you want to be. Go for it, man. It doesn't stop. Live your life.
Well,
if you want to be nasty about it openly, go for it. I don't have to be.
Yeah, but no
but
one
if
is,
I'm not that kind of
you
person,
keep
I don't have
arguing
to think.
This stuff that no one is arguing. No one is saying you shouldn't do that. What I'm saying is that we shouldn't.
Why should you celebrate it? Why should you tell me what to celebrate?
Why should you tell us what is women empowerment?
I'm
saying that to us it's not women empowerment.
To you, it's not women empowerment.
And that's what I'm saying. You need voices to be able to speak back against that.
You need those
balances. That's all I'm saying.
Make sure you guys go stream WAP.
Look, here's the thing. I'm not telling anyone to go stream WAP. I'm not telling anyone to go stream WAP.
If your kids are out here listening to this podcast,
what I'm saying is that
I swear
there
a lot on
needs
here,
to be
so
a balance.
I think your kids shouldn't be listening to this podcast.
There needs to be. I don't make it for kids, and I make sure I don't make it for kids. This is us adults talking. This is us adults talking, right? And at some point, right, we have to take ownership of where the culture leads us. And I think if we don't have enough
can
balance
lead us in
voices,
multiple directions, we don't have to go on road.
Yes, and that's what we're doing. We have to debate these things, and we actually have to be able to argue, okay, why is this thing empowering? You're not making that argument by telling me, oh, it's empowering just because Cardi is showing her titties.
What does empowering mean to you?
Empowering?
Yeah, what does that word mean to you?
It means it's something that I mean, look up the definition, read it out.
Empowering says to give someone the authority or power to do something. That's it.
No one ever took that authority or power.
There are a lot of people who are hiding their sexuality.
No one is going to see.
A lot of people who have a high sex drive and are scared to talk about it because society tells you that if as a woman you do that, you're a hoe.
What society is telling you
this
that?
This society tells you.
Till today.
In
U.S. culture?
In the world, yeah.
No one
society still tells you that
You're a hoe.
So what society? Which publication? Like now,
it's not publication.
No. But I gave you an example.
Is it not the same
right?
examples people are giving on the tweets about this song?
No, no. I gave you.
There's one side of people
complex,
like, yes, girl,
complex
nasty
as an
shit.
Example. As an example, I'm not talking about just individuals. I gave you complex as an example. Complex is an entertainment, hip hop culture.
How often does Complex promote?
I just gave you an example.
But prior to WAP, how often has Complex come out to talk about, you know, women's sexuality?
I don't know. I mean, that's
so
not,
it's not like they do it often. It's not like this thing is out there often. This is just something.
But I gave you an example. Okay. What I'm saying is that can you give me an example of a publication that's geared towards kids, that's telling kids that
forget
oh, no,
kids,
people,
man. Like, MJ said, fuck them
kids. Markets
them kids,
to kids.
Fuck them kids. Look.
We'll never kids, see eye,
eye,
because
eye on this topic. I don't think we'll it's up see, to eye, someone eye else to raise my kids for me if
no,
I have kids.
No one is telling you that.
Because
these
same kids know Pornhub and all the
But messaging porn is important. Messaging is important.
Links out there. So
I know. But messaging
you, so
is
if
important.
You take out WAP, all the kid has to do is, these kids have pornography on their
no one is telling
phone.
you keep arguing, no one is arguing that you should take
would you
out
not
WAP?
Rather let them be expressive of it and then you can teach
no
them
one
and
is,
say hey okay this is how
no one is arguing that you shouldn't express. I'm saying that we shouldn't celebrate it as a symbol of empowerment. There's nothing empowering about showing your titties and ass. There's nothing empowering about it. That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying don't do it. I'm saying that
it makes
I'm
you feel sexy.
I'm saying that publications like Complex should not
what if it makes
should
feel
not
good?
Put that on a pedestal. What if what makes you feel good? Would you want your daughter doing that? Huh? No, period.
But does
so,
Megan
so, so
the Stallion's
there's nothing
father
empowering
have a
about
with?
It.
Does her father have a problem?
Her father is dead, and her mom is dead too.
R.I.P. to her parents. Do Cardi's parents have a problem with it?
I don't know.
Okay, maybe
it's
not
about Cardi. It's not about Cardi's parents.
His other kids. Okay.
You're losing the point.
You're saying that
you're missing the point. It's not about Cardi's parents. It's not about Cardi. I'm not. Look, they deserve the right to do whatever video
what
that
about
they
strippers?
Want to do.
Should they not be empowered?
I don't. What do you mean by empowered?
Should they not be glad that there's a song representing their movement?
What of what social value does it bring? You tell me.
What social value does strippers bring to start with?
No. I said, no. You said that are they not empowered? Yeah. Of what social value does it bring? Like, would you if you're saying that this is a good thing, would you want your daughter
so
to be a stripper?
Here's
have you heard
my,
the joke
here's
the
my,
Chris Rock made?
Yes, that you made a mistake as a dad.
That
yeah,
if there's one mistake
yeah,
that you
yeah,
made,
I know,
is the way you know that you fucked up.
If your girl
is if you're
poor. Guy, I'm not going to be hypocritical as a man. We've been to the strip club before.
Yes,
you and
no.
I have been to the strip club before.
Yes,
we can't say we didn't enjoy being in there. So I can't come and say we're as a stripper. You failed. I mean, hey, they did their job.
No, there's talent there too.
Yeah,
it's not just there's the talent there.
Meg Thee Stallion's WAP does not empower me, but I cannot say it doesn't empower someone else.
Empower them to do what?
Be free. Own up to their sexuality. Own up to their.
Let's move on. Let's
sex
move on.
Drive.
Let's
and,
move on.
We
don't see eye to eye on this one. This is one that we'll never see eye to eye on. But
go stream it. Make it number one. It's the number one actually.
Smiling surfer of the week. Who you got?
Oh no, man. I think Burna still, bro.
Burna?
Still riding that wave, man.
I don't know, man. I was hoping he would make that top 20. Who's I really was. I really, really was praying
really
for
done
it.
Nobody anything this week.
Surfer. Who's taking L's this week? You got nothing?
Maybe Kemi Onoluo. Reportive investigative journalist from Ibadan.
Nah, I wouldn't really consider that an L. Sofra, she didn't really suffer now. She's not
suffer. She's just an Agbaya. Sofra, I don't know. Who's suffering? I don't know.
Tory, man.
Oh yeah, Tory.
Tory nah. is taking that. He needs to come out and put out a statement
right.
of some kind.
Tory is the sufferer.
He needs to put out some kind
of
statement of some
year,
kind.
Man.
He needs to put out
week.
Some
suffer. Sufferer of the year, you know.
I don't think anyone in particular is winning this week.
He wraps up 2020 in a nutshell.
Shitori?
Yeah.
If they
it's a fucked up year, man.
If they put deport that guy, he will.
Yeah, at least he's getting deported to Canada. He'll be alright.
I know.
Well, I think getting deported to Canada is kind of painful because you're like so close. You can't do. As in, like, in terms of someone who's prominent in this industry, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, man.
No, his bags are going to be.
His
stopped.
Bags are here. Like, yeah. His money is here. So he's like, bro, like. I'm so close, you know. I can't even.
He'll
go
do.
On a
he'll
world tour.
Do.
Maybe, hey, Tory, man,
do.
Africa.
He'll make
go
do.
Sing in Africa.
Yeah, man. So
go
yeah.
sing in Europe.
Tory is high. Still taking those L's this year, man.
But that's even if he's a free man. So,
as far as who's winning, I can't think of anyone. I can't really think of anyone that's winning. I mean, any major.
Give your closing song, man.
Before we go, have you been following playoffs?
Yeah, man.
Lakers took that L now.
Yeah, but we bounced.
Is there
back.
A game today?
We bounce back. Is it today or tomorrow? I think it's today.
It's today?
Today or tomorrow? I think it's today. We bounce back, bro. We dominated them niggas, man. We had to remind them, man, look. This is the Lake Show, bro.
Milwaukee also got,
you know, so it came. I think it's still going to be Lakers Bucks final.
Lakers Bucks. You want to put money on it?
Yeah, I really hope not, because I'm not confident we can beat the Bucks over.
That guy should be back very soon, right? Rondo.
Rondo is coming, but he might come back in this next game.
You guys had Beal, right?
Beal?
Yeah. Something Beal. What's his name?
You think of Avery Bradley.
Avery Bradley. Like Beal.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, but then he sat out because of BLM.
Let me see. I didn't follow his...
He sat out now. He's supposed to be in the Lakers. Yeah. And it's funny. I used to be a Lakers fan. I haven't really been able to be a Lakers fan since LeBron started at Lakers.
You know what's funny? It's like, it's did he sit out? He hasn't played. You know what?
He sat out because of BLM. I'm telling you. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a protest.
You know what?
He's one of the people that sat out with that guy from, what's his name?
No, he says Lakers Avery Bradley ups out of NBA restart, cites family concerns.
Oh, it's not because of BLM.
No, yeah.
So it's just because of Corona.
You know what I was noticing? I was like, you know what? I noticed he wasn't, I thought it was injured.
Yeah, no, I know he opted out. Oh. I know it wasn't an injury. It wasn't an injury. The team I'm rooting for right now, Mavs.
Mavs are not going to beat.
I know. The Clippers are too strong.
Clippers now. It's 2-1 now.
There's something about that Doncic.
Clippers won yesterday.
Yeah, they did. It's not about that Doncic kid.
Yeah,
man.
Look at Doncic.
He's a sniper,
he's,
man.
He's like, someone put it one side. He's like the Mbappe of.
It doesn't make sense. I look at this Oyinbo guy. That's like, he doesn't even all that fit, but you see what he does on the
he's
court.
A baller, man. He's young.
And then you see the Porzingis, the way he's. You know, like me, I don't really.
I mean, getting Porzingis was a good move for them.
So me, I don't follow NBA. I hardly follow NBA during the regular season. But watching this guy just nail threes, and he's tall. It doesn't make any sense. It makes no sense. Like, it looks so weird. But yeah, I'm kind of rooting for
them. To be honest, the problem that I feel Lakers we have is we don't have a shooter. And you know,
how about that Caruso? Doesn't he shoot?
They're not as efficient with Danny Green.
But then didn't they get that guy? The tattooed guy. What's his name? The guy that used to be on Cleveland Cavs with him.
Oh, fuck. The one that missed the shots at the end. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about, the tired guy.
Yeah, but he's always had this lazy eye.
He
balled actually last game. He came in and balled last game. Fuck, how have I forgotten this guy's name, man?
I forgot his name too.
Yeah, how did I forget it? He came on the last game and he actually balled.
We need
shooters. Danny Green has been a flop.
He's been, like.
I was reminded by a fellow fan, is that, you know, Danny Green be coming up, you know, when he in the finals. But we have to make it to the finals first, man.
Danny Green has won championships. So
he did it at Spurs. Yeah, Raptors. Yeah, he was clutch in the finals. So, you know, hopefully. But I'm glad Rondo is coming back.
I was going to bring something up, but Onyade is not here. But she had made a point about why we celebrate this sports artist, and it really, really had me thinking.
It's today.
Yeah. It really, really had me thinking. But we'll finish that next time.
I think whoever wins this game is going to win the series.
Which game?
This Lakers game today. I feel like if we don't win this game today,
it'll be 2-2 now.
It's 1-1 right now.
No, it's 2-1.
1-1.
Okay, yeah. It's 1-1.
I don't want the Blazers going up again, because it's not even a good look, man. Those guys, they can't defend, man. Like, they're
Lillard.
You have
man.
Lillard and
Damian Lillard is on a tear right now.
Dame time, man.
But he injured his
Yeah, but they said he will just play with a tape on or something right. like that.
But yeah, man, we gotta go, man. So, Wale, can you introduce this last song for us?
Bro, I just stumbled across the song one day on Twitter, man. It's called
Where do you find these guys?
I just find songs.
His name, Sev, I can barely pronounce it.
Damiel Feist. The song is called Boomba.
Damiel Feist.
I don't even know these guys. I don't know.
All right, let's see what this is.
I don't even know what year this song came out, to be honest. I think this song
came out
2020. Okay, yeah. But I just stumbled
across it. Well, it was on Spotify in 2020. Yeah,
it says July 24, 2020. And it's called Boomba.
Boomba. Enjoy. All right, before we go, please, guys, don't forget to follow us, man. Follow us on IG, Instagram, where smiling_suffer. That's on IG. On Twitter, we're at smilingpod. And on Facebook, we're on smilingsufferer. Please search for us. The last episode, for some reason, it didn't upload on Spotify. We apologize for that. I think it might have had to do with some copyright issues because we played that whole album last week. But don't worry, we're going to get it fixed. We're going to start posting on SoundCloud also, so watch out for those links. Please don't forget to like, subscribe. Subscribe on our YouTube page. Please, please. We need to get our followership up. Thank you very much. And this is Boomba by Damiel Feist. Check this out.
You guys do playing. You guys suck.
Sorry. Sorry.
Pull up on me yard with all the clues. Me and want you, me and want all the clues. Pull up on me yard with all the clues. Me and want you, me and want all the clues. Yeah. Can a girl say she like the way I do the thing that I do to her? Say she like it when I put my hands all over her body like that. She like it when I give her the boomba, the boomba, the boomba, the slower. She like it when I give her the boomba, the boomba, the boomba, the slower. Oh yeah, baby, come to papi, give you exactly what you want in. No time for story, get on the bed of your panties. Let me give you the cucumba, make you feel nice, make you feel alright. Let me give you the cucumba, make you feel nice, make you feel alright, yeah. Me no one waste your time, girl, I ain't trying to talk all night. Tell me what's on your mind, girl, I'm just trying to please you right. Take it slow, till you lose control. We go take it slow, till you lose control. Can a girl say she like the way I do the thing that I do to her? Say she like it when I put my hands all over her body like that. She like it when I give her the boomba, the boomba, the boomba, the slower. She like it when I give her the boomba, the boomba, the boomba, the slower. Oh yeah. The thing you do me, girl, it make me one day lose my mind. Can't deny this feeling, now you way they making my head a banana. My heart a kululu, you make my head a banana. My heart a kululu for you. Hey. Pull up, wine, wind up your waistline, wine. Pull up, wine, wind up your waistline, wine. Money go pull up, wine, wind up your waistline, wine. Pull up. Wine, move up your waistline, wine. Can a girl say she like the way I do the thing that I do to her? Say she like it when I put my hands all over her body like that. Can a girl say she like the way I do the things that I do to her? Say she like the way I put my hands all over her body like that. She like it when I give her the boomba, the boomba, the boomba, the slower. She like it when I give her the boomba. Boomba, give her the boomba.